See, it was so precariously put. All right, again, thank you everybody for coming today for this very important announcement from the city. And with that, I'll turn it over to Flint Mayor Dane Wallen.
Well, thank you and good morning, everyone. I also I want to just tell you how we have a lot of information that we want to share today, and we're very pleased that we have Mark Valachek, the county health officer and director of the Genesee County Health Department, here with us. So I'm going to give a few initial remarks to get us started and introduce and have Mr. Mark Valachek provide the perspective from the Genesee County Health Department and answer your questions that you have directly for him. I'm sure there's also some broader issues around Flint's water and infrastructure that we want to be able to cover. So after Mr. Mark Valachek, then the city administrator will come up for remarks, and we'll be able to take those questions about the rest of the system. So, of course, we're all available here to answer your questions, but I think we want to make sure we give appropriate attention to the county health officer and the message that he has for our residents. So today, the city of Flint is issuing a lead advisory. We want this community to be aware that no level of lead is healthy. We need to do everything we can to prevent exposure to lead in our community, and we want to be, we're thankful for the county's health department's partnership in providing a lead in drinking water fact sheet that Mr. Mark Valachek, our county health officer, will talk about, and the steps that everyone in our community can take. Today, I also want to share that I'm extremely concerned about any risks of lead exposure and elevated lead in our community. We all have to take steps to address this challenge. There are steps we can take immediately. There are also action steps that the city and our partners, Department of Environmental Quality and EPA, will be taking in the midterm and in the long term. The goal is for Flint to be lead-free, for us to include the necessary capital improvements in our plan to remove lead from this community, so that whatever our water source and situation is, that we are providing a safe environment for all of Flint's families, especially our children. Now, as a father, I want every family and household in the city of Flint to be safe and secure. That's hard work, but if we work together, if we share information and bring in the necessary financial investments from our state and federal partners, then I'm confident that we can reach that goal. So I want to talk more about those infrastructure questions or issues later. But now I want to turn to Mr. Mark Valachek again, the county health officer and director of the Genesee County Health Department. Mr. Valachek.
Thank you, Mayor. I want to make it clear that the water, as it's coming from the water treatment plant, is meeting the federal EPA guidelines. The agency that has responsibility for municipal water in Michigan is the Michigan Department of Environmental Quality, and we at the County Health Department have been in contact with them on a regular basis as challenges have occurred with the Flint water supply. One of the things, though, that public needs to understand is the only way to know whether or not you have a lead problem is to understand whether you've got potential lead piping, lead solder, galvanized piping in your home that may be leaching lead from the water while it's sitting overnight in your house. So the best way to find that out, because you can't taste this, you can't smell it, you have to get your water tested. The city has offered to test water for the residents, and we would encourage anyone with a concern to contact the city and get their water tested. Now, as an immediate measure, at the health department, we got authorization from the state and the feds to provide ready-made formula to any household where they have a test result where the lead standard is above the EPA limit. So anyone participating in the WIC program who's gotten their water tested, there is the option for ready-made formula. They're also, through efforts from the local community partners and the United Way, the diaper bank does have, in addition to diapers, bottled water available. So individuals, for example, with infant powdered formula, if they're uncertain about their water supply, they should contact the diaper bank. Water is also available for anyone who has a bridge or SNAP card. It's something that can be purchased with those benefits. Again, the highest risk population are pregnant women and infants and young children. The health department also offers blood lead testing. We do that routinely as part of our WIC program. So if there are individuals with young children who need to be tested, they should first contact their healthcare provider, but anyone who doesn't have a provider can talk to the health department about getting a blood lead test done.
Yeah, I think so. While we have the county health director here with us, let's go ahead and take questions specifically to the services and support that the county health department's able to offer.
Are you suggesting that elderly who have systems that's immune system that's compromised and the sickly, since they don't run in the category of children or youth or babies, that they're not at risk? Is that what you're saying, doctor, that elderly, the sickly, elderly, don't worry about them. Just the children and the baby, you know, they can go get their snaps and food, snap food, whatever. And the elderly who are not on any type of assistance, but their Social Security, and they're sick and their immune system is very compromised. Are you suggesting and telling us or the public that don't worry about them?
No, lead is not as iron is a micronutrient. It's nothing the body needs, and it has no positive benefits. So there's the goal should be for no lead to be in the water supply.
So they are at risk.
They are. There is a potential risk to anyone to elevated lead levels.
Okay. So I mean, I'm a rapper, but do you think that we should just go back to a different water source? Should Flint go and have a different water source? I mean, that, you know, we can just come to the chase. You know, people are not drinking the water. We're scared to death to drink the water. Would you suggest that we go to a different water source?
I think that there are initiatives underway to look at how we can reduce the lead levels in the water supply. And there are a number of different alternatives that might be investigated.
Why has it taken this long to come out with some sort of warning, or is there any answer for that?
Well, in part, it's based upon testing that's done. You know, there was you need to have data. You've got to have concrete data, and I'm going to be quite honest. There's some conflicting data right now in terms of the results that have been presented. So as we move forward, we'll have more data and be able to justify more likely additional resources coming into the community. I mean, that's a critical element anytime you're going after resources, whether it's in Lansing or Washington. You've got to have the data behind it. Can't be anecdotal stories. They may help initiate some conversation on a subject, but what Lansing and Washington want to see is some concrete data on what the problem is and then what we might do. It's interesting that Washington, D.C. actually had this same problem about 10 years ago. And we've been in contact with some of the individuals there to see what initiatives were taken as a result of them discovering the same problem, to see if we can't learn from what they did and have a quicker response here in Flint.
When people go to the city to get their water tested, right now the city's methodology is to tell people to pre-flush their systems. But Miguel Totoro from the EPA, Professor Mark Edwards, said that's absolutely should not be done if you want to get an accurate reading of lead in water. So when you're advising people to go to the city and get their water tested, are you telling them that they should pre-flush, or are you telling them not to pre-flush in order to get the most accurate levels of lead in their tests?
I think based upon what you're telling me, it may be a good idea for the health department to work with the city and to come up with some concrete black and white instructions on what's recommended based upon the EPA standard.
You're talking about the concrete data. Do you consider the information that Hurley put out yesterday to be concrete data?
I know that the State Department of Health and Human Services is looking at that data and comparing it to data that they have collected. The state actually has more extensive data covering a longer period of time and has more individuals, and we're very interested in finding out what the state data, if it will corroborate that story, or whether there are differences based upon the larger sample size.
And is that data public information, the state data, or are they still in the process of?
My understanding is that analysis is going on right now.
Okay, and then one more question. You mentioned the formula that will be given out. So how do you qualify? You have to be above the EPA guideline for lead or any source of lead in your water?
Basically, you have to have a test from a reputable source. So the Flint Water Department is offering free testing. There are also private labs. The DEQ also has a lab. Any of those certified sources, if your level is above that, then you need to work with your WIC nutritionist and we can switch the formula to ready mix.
If your level is above what?
What's the number?
The EPA standard.
15 parts per billion?
All right.
That's not what's being tested. That's not what the data that Hurley is coming out are not above the EPA guidelines. So there's a discrepancy, obviously, then, in what the EPA guidelines are and what these tests are showing.
Then the recommendation would be to use the bottled water that's available from the diaper bank if you fall below that line.
You were talking about having lead service lines and lead soldering in your pipes and not knowing. When is the city going to release where the lead service lines on their part are to the citizens' homes to let those citizens know that the lead service line isn't on their part but on the city's part and when it's going to be fixed with this going on in our community?
We'll take that after the question.
Okay.
Do you have any special guidance for daycare centers and schools in town for how they handle, providing water for kids and lunches and all that?
Well, the best recommendation is to first have your water tested to see what the levels are, to see what initiatives you might want to undertake. There are filters that are available that can be utilized, but you need to know what's the correct certification. You know, it's kind of interesting that the standard for faucet, you can advertise it as lead-free, and it can still contain up to 8% lead. But there's other warning labels that will tell you that it doesn't contain any amount of lead. So one of the things that we're trying to educate, and we've developed a fact sheet to assist in this process is, what type of filter do I need to look for if I have that concern?
Mark, as the public's guardian of health in Genesee County, what can you say to people? Are you turning your tap water on at home, and are you drinking the water, and how concerned are you about this? On a scale of 1 to 10, how big of a deal is this for the Genesee County Health Department?
Well, in addition to being the health officer, I'm also faculty at U of M. And I drink the water there because I know the university has tested the various faucets. Where they run into problems, they've intervened or they have closed the faucets. So I think you don't know in this case if you've got a lead problem unless you do the testing.
You talked about that Washington, D.C. went through the same problems with lead. Mark Edwards from Virginia Tech is the one who did all the studying there and broke that problem there. So why are you not taking his findings seriously, and why are you not utilizing him in this situation? Why did, I mean, us citizens brought him in here and did the testing here, so why are you guys not utilizing that?
We have utilized him. We've met with him, and he's agreed to share his data with us, and we're awaiting those findings.
I just want to double back real quick, Mark. How concerned specifically is the Genesee County Health Department about the levels of lead that are being shown in the testing in both the Virginia Tech samples, the Hurley samples that came out yesterday, and the DEQ? How concerned are you as the Genesee County Health Department about these findings?
We're very concerned, just as was expressed yesterday. No amount of lead is of any benefit. So we want to reduce the exposure as much as we can. But there are going to be challenges for us. It's not something that you can detect by smell or taste, so you've got to do the sample.
Hey, could I ask a question real quick? You stated at the onset that the water coming out of the plant was safe. You made a point of saying that in this press conference. My understanding is that the treatment in the Flint River water is more corrosive than lake water, and that has something to do with what happens when it hit the infrastructure. Why is it necessary for you to emphasize the quality of water meeting standards coming out of the plant when really the problem, as you seem to see it, has something to do with pipes? What is the connection and the relevancy, and how soon and fast do we analyze the various pipes seem to be what the health department, how do you address that urgency?
Well, I think one of the challenges, as you mentioned, is the water from the current source is resulting in water that's more corrosive than the previous source, and that presents additional challenges. But the water from the plant is meeting the EPA and DEQ standards. That's what I'm basing that upon.
How is that possible if we didn't have this lead problem prior to this, before the switch?
Because the lead is being introduced once this water sits in the pipes.
No, according to the studies from Virginia Tech, the water from the river is 19 times more corrosive than Detroit water.
Correct.
So how's not that the source of the problem? If the river water is so corrosive that it's causing lead to leach into it and get into the bodies of pregnant women and infants and children, how can you stand there and say the river water is safe when it's the direct cause of the lead that is getting into people's bodies?
I believe the director stated that there is a discrepancy in data, and that's one of the things that we're working on. So to use one source over another at this point is premature.
So you're saying the water is still safe, even though you're saying it's not safe because there's too much lead in it. You're saying two different things at the same time. It's safe and it's not safe.
The water
correct?
The plant is safe.
But it's not safe to drink.
Depending on your service line. That's why we encourage, again and again, get your water tested.
So you're saying it's not the problem is not the corrosive river water, which
I'm
has been proved
here, so I just wanted you to stay on track. And I would ask that members of the media ask the questions here. And
I am the media.
We thank the members of the public for being here, and but this is a press conference.
I am the media.
So.
I am a member of the media.
Okay, I am the media.
They're talking about me, guys. You know the whole reason why this is happening.
All right, so let's get back on track. Mr. Belichick. Any more questions?
Another question? No.
I think, I mean, he's got a valid point. I mean, are you saying the water is safe to drink? I mean, that's, he's
hey,
got
Kurt,
a good question. That
move up here so you can ask my questions.
Again, my statement is the water as it's coming from the plant is meeting the EPA and DEQ standards. What is the problem is that once it enters the house, we need to understand whether or not the lead is being introduced, leaching from the lines, from basically the city system to your faucet. The only way to do that is to have your water tested.
If someone has not had their water tested, would you suggest they not drink water?
I would not want to drink water unless I was aware that it was safe. And given the fact that we've made people aware that there is a potential problem, I would want to be assured that I have safe water.
How is the city going to handle an influx of people coming and saying, I want it, my water tested? I mean...
That's in the next
part. Okay.
Given the fact that you have the highly credible Mark Edwards in Virginia Tech saying that the water's not safe, and based on the city's and MDEQ testing saying the water as it's coming out of the plant is safe, do you think there's reason to call into question the way the city and MDEQ conducted their tests?
I think the focus of the MDEQ has been on assuring that the city meets EPA guidelines. And my concern is that that may not protect individual public health for every resident of this community, because we're not sampling every tap. We don't know what your interior plumbing is. The city is meeting the standards in terms of collecting the number of samples, doing the analysis, and meeting the EPA guidelines.
That wasn't my question. My question is, given the discrepancy between both the Virginia Tech findings and now the Hurley study and what the city and state are claiming, those are two contradictory things. Because of that, do you think it is prudent to investigate the way the city and state are conducting the test to see if they are not doing it correctly because they don't comport with what Virginia Tech and Hurley has found?
To comment, I would need to actually see the data from the Virginia Tech study, which I have not yet done.
It's been posted from day one. They've been putting it on their website.
Well, we do have some other things we want to cover. I want to thank Mr. Valchek. Some of you may know that the County Health Department works every day tirelessly on a range of environmental health concerns, including lead poisoning. As we've all spent more time looking at the data and information that's available, I can tell you from the state summary that was shared with the number of tests done on individuals in the city of Flint in the recent couple years. This was prior to the change in water supply in calendar year 2012 and 2013. There were more than 300 cases in the city of Flint of youth under the age of 16 that were tested and shown to have an elevated blood lead level. I mean, this is a serious challenge. And while the data from different sources may point to different conclusions, I asked these same questions to the EPA officials that I met with on Tuesday afternoon in Washington, D.C. They told me that the National Drinking Water Advisory Council is debating the exact same questions that you're asking here today about what the standard level should be, what the testing procedure should be. What we can tell you from the city of Flint and what you have in our lead advisory is that there are steps that every individual, every household in the city of Flint can take. And these are steps that individuals probably should have been taking in recent years. We've had lead in our pipes now for decades. You may have plastic pipes in your house, but you may have a lead service line underground connecting you to the water main. So there's a variety of factors, but as the County Health Department fact sheet mentioned, every household should be flushing cold water pipes for 5 minutes, only using cold water for drinking, cooking, and especially for making baby formula if it's not able to be purchased already constituted or made with bottled water. And households can look at installing filters at the tap that are
NSF certified for lead control.
Okay, not this our
district
question.
Chief of staff from Congressman Kildee's office.
If the water is good at the plant, right? Yeah. Everyone agrees the testing at the plant is good. Is there any way for citizens to bring containers to the plant and get water there that's safe for drinking when they, in the meantime?
Let's discuss that internally. Okay. We'll take that as a suggestion. So I just wanted to reiterate the work that the County Health Department is doing around lead poison prevention in our community. I think that's important work. It's ongoing. You will continue to make available the blood lead testing. So that's important. We want to also talk about, you know, today the other steps that are being taken to improve the city's water. We have to work on every level as fast as possible. We're issuing the lead advisory so households can take the necessary steps. City staff are taking the necessary steps. And I'm asking for federal and state support on the long-term infrastructure improvements that we know we need for our water system, as well as for the lead threat that's underground in our service lines that will need to be replaced for Flint to be able to be lead-free. So I'm going to introduce the city administrator to talk about the steps the city is taking to include corrosion control in the city's water system to make it comparable with the Detroit water supply, and other steps that we're taking with our technical advisory team and staff to continue to improve Flint's water. So City Administrator Natasha Henderson.
Mayor, can I just jump in really quick just while we're on the subject? You know, the decision to go to Detroit Water was made under the emergency manager.
Correct.
Why are they not represented here? I mean, it seems that Darnell Early skipped town and the decisions have been made and they're in place and they've affected everybody. Why isn't somebody from the state represented? I mean, that was under his control, so to speak. I mean, is that question been answered for you?
You're talking about the State Department. I know the State Department of Environmental Quality has issued a number of statements.
No, I'm saying
that or the governor's office.
Yeah, the governor's office. I mean, has there been contact? Hey, you came in here, changed all of these things, and now there's underlying problems. Where are they at?
My point exactly.
Mayor, to follow up on that question, were you supportive of Darnell Early's, the emergency manager, going to the Flint River Water? Were you in support of that move by the emergency manager at that time?
Yeah, that was not my decision.
But were you supportive?
I raised a number of questions about that during the process. At the point that decision was made and budgeted and implemented, then, you know, I stood with the rest of the city officials and was part of that change. But it was not my decision. I raised a number of concerns about it throughout the process. But ultimately, that is the water that was being provided to our community. And I've worked diligently with the information that's been available to me. I take responsibility now for finding solutions. You know that we've focused very intently on the TTHM challenges. Once those were identified, made available to myself and City Council, and I had the ability, along with the new city administrator, to make those decisions. We worked as fast as possible to get the carbon filter installed, and that's what brought us into compliance with the Safe Drinking Water Act. But we are going to go above and beyond in the city of Flint to provide all the information possible to our customers, to do everything possible within the resources we have available. And every single day, I'm going to ask for more support for this community from our federal and state agencies. There are problems that can be fixed with greater funding. There are issues that can be better addressed with more technical assistance. And I'm asking and working on those every single day.
What do you tell a scientist who say the problem is the Flint River and its high corrosivity that's directly leading to the lead problem? And they have the Hurley study now, which shows a correlation between before and after. You have the Virginia Tech study, which shows high degree of lead, and they lay it
They show the tests that they're doing, that it's directly related to the corrosivity. So how can you, what do you say to those people that say the problem is the river and the river is not safe?
This is exactly why the city administrator is coming up next to tell you about it.
But I'd like to hear what the mayor has to say about that.
We'll come back to questions. Let us tell you the steps that we're taking to
we've
provide
just been answering
corrosion
a bunch of questions,
control
mayor.
Into the city of Flint water supply. Okay.
We are very focused on dealing with the lead issue at this point. This is not something that could have been predicted. So we are with the Flint River, that's the source, and we will do whatever we have to do to deal with the lead issue. First, we have issued a lead advisory. So we would like the public to have that information and all that that entails, and steps that you can take to try to ensure that you're not exposed to lead. Also, we are currently working with the DEQ to get a corrosion control implemented in the next 30 to 90 days. And I say 30 to 90 days because there's an approval process that we have to go through before we can implement that, and that is something that we're doing to be very proactive in dealing with this. Although the city is in compliance with the Safe Water Drinking Act, we feel it is a duty of the city as the city administrator, also as the public works director, the mayor, us representing the city, to listen to the concerns and take proactive measures, even though we continue to be in compliance with the Safe Water Drinking Act. So we do hear all of those concerns and we are trying to address that. Also, infrastructure on the city side, we have a capital improvement plan at this time that a lot of those plans have been halted for financial reasons. So the city, this is definitely an urgent matter because when residents, constituents in the medical community come to us with this concern, we do react to that. So I would like to say that we are very concerned and we will be taking those measures and steps to contain the lead levels in the water. Also, we would like for everyone to share the information about the lead advisory. It's very important that residents have this information and actually abide by that information because we want to be proactive and ensure that residents do know there's nothing that the city is trying to hide. We're being as transparent as possible. So we would like for that lead advisory to be really focused on. We have the media here.